Okay, students, yesterday we have started ether compound. Nomenclature we have done, isomerism we have done. So today I will do how to prepare the ethers in the laboratory, I mean the methods of preparation of ethers. So to prepare the ether, the most important method that is called Williamson method, and which is commonly called Williamson ether synthesis. This reaction already you have got in Halliwell-Ganz chapter. So what is the reaction? When haloalkane reacts with sodium alkoxide, this is your example of haloalkane. Zanel formula I have written. Haloalkane when react with sodium alkoxide, then this sodium combines with this halogen and they will form sodium halide like sodium chloride, sodium bromide, and this R combines with this OR, they form the ether. For example, if you want to write one example, suppose this is your haloalkane methyl bromide or bromomethane. When it reacts with sodium methoxide, then it goes to methoxymethane and side product will be NaBr. So like this way you can prepare ethers. This reaction, by using this reaction, you can prepare symmetrical ether also, unsymmetrical ether also. I mean, your haloalkane is bromoethane and your alkoxide is sodium methoxide. Then it can produce methoxyethane like this. Side product will be NaBr. So here both side contains similar alkyl group, that's why this type of ethers are called symmetrical ether. Here both side contain different alkyl group, that's why these are called unsymmetrical or mixed ether. So one of the character of this reaction is you can prepare both symmetrical and unsymmetrical ether. But this reaction have a limitation also, I mean this reaction have a drawback also. This reaction follow SN2 mechanism. I mean this is one example of nucleophilic substitution. The X minus ion is replaced by the RO minus ion. Since negative ion is replaced by another negative, that's why this type of reactions are called nucleophilic substitution reaction. And as you know, nucleophilic substitution reaction follow two types of mechanism, SN1 and SN2. But this Williamson reaction, it follows SN2 mechanism, and due to SN2 mechanism, a proper choice of reactant is necessary. Have you got it? What is the drawback? Since the reaction follow SN2 mechanism, that is why a proper choice of reactant is necessary. If you are not understanding about this, you consider this example. Suppose you want to prepare this ether. If you want to prepare this ether, then you can prepare by taking this reactant, sodium combines with bromine, they produce NaBr, and this part, this alkyl group combined with OCH3, it produces this, and side product will be NaBr. And someone can written like this way also, CH3Br plus CH3CCH3 tertiary butyl, I mean sodium tertiary butoxide. Someone can take like this way also, then also it goes to this. Side product will be NaBr, and this one combined with methyl group, you will get this. Now there is a difference between these two. If someone written this one, it will be wrong. If someone written this one will be correct. And why this one is correct? As I have told you, the reaction follow SN2 mechanism. Tertiary haloalkane cannot show SN2 mechanism, you know. To undergo SN2 mechanism, the haloalkane must be primary. That is why I have told you, since the reaction follow SN2 mechanism, so when you consider the reactant, a proper selection of reactant is necessary. If you make haloalkane tertiary, it will become wrong. So haloalkane must be primary, then the SN2 mechanism will take place, and this is the drawback of this reaction. Now, if I asked you, you have to prepare this ether this is tertiary butyl group, this is also tertiary butyl group, di tertiary butyl ether, this one you have to prepare by applying Williamson reaction. I mean this ether you have to prepare. What reactant you will take? Then, as you know, this is one tertiary group, this is also one tertiary group. So when the haloalkane you will consider, the haloalkane must be tertiary. And tertiary haloalkane cannot show SN2 mechanism. That is why this ether, I mean di tertiary butyl ether, you cannot prepare by applying Williamson method. So this is the drawback of this method. So one alkyl group must be in primary state, then you can prepare the ether. So this ether you cannot prepare due to presence of both side tertiary group. So this is the drawback. Now, second method, number two. By reaction of alkyl halide with dry silver oxide. This is another method to prepare the ethers. The reaction is like this. This is your alkyl halide or haloalkane. Alkyl halide and haloalkane both are same. When it reacts with silver oxide Az2O, then it will convert it to ROR. Side product will be twice AgX. Actually, the reaction is like this. Here 2RX, these are 2RX. And this is your silver oxide Az2O. This silver will take the halogen, it will produce twice AgX side product, and this R combined with this oxygen and this R combined, they will produce ROR. Like this way the reaction will take place. And if you want to take one example, suppose twice CH3 beer bromomethane, when you react with silver oxide, then silver combines with bromine, it produces twice AgBr, and this methyl group combines with oxygen, they will produce methoxymethane. So this is also one method to prepare the ether by using silver oxide. But this reaction also have one drawback. You can prepare only symmetrical ether. By applying this method, you cannot prepare the unsymmetrical ethers. So this is about second method. Now, Number three method from alkene you can prepare ether. This is one alkene, it may be ethene, it may be propene, like that. When it combines with alcohol CH3OH, suppose this is your alcohol. Since alcohols are acidic in nature, it can release H plus N to CH3O minus H plus N. According to Marco Rico's rule, negative is added to that double bonded carbon which contains less number of hydrogen. So here OCH3 will be joined, double bond is converted to single bond, it goes to CH3. Like this way also you can make the ether. For example, this is propene. When propene is treated with methanol, you will get this one. Its name will be 1, 2, 3, 2 methoxy propane. So like this way you can prepare ether. This is the number 3 method. Thank you.